إلا له ومن يدرك فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. My brothers in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum
assalam wa rahmatullahi. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the grace of His beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was brought us today, alhamdulillah, for Dars-e Hadith, to learn those hadiths, those actions of our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, so that we can follow the straight path. It is said that we have started the hadith where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ, to the words of our Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْكَ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ, that all your actions revolves around your intention. So the person that wrote this book, the person that compiled it, Shaykh Imam Muhammad, he wanted you to understand that he compiled this book and his intention was khalis, that whoever reads it, there was benefit from it. So inshallah, we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the sawab of today's dars also goes to him as well. The first riwayat, alhamdulillah, was the riwayat by Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. As we said, the Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he became a Muslim, Islam spread widely. In a sense that Islam was very small, it was done in a place that was hidden, that people didn't know. They used to get together, make the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have their meetings and go away. And when Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala, who became a Muslim, when his eyes went on the beloved face of our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he fell to the feet of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he read the kalma la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala. He was that kind of sahabi, he was very close. And the four khalifas of Islam, he was the second khalifa. After Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala was the second khalifa. And as Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala, he said, as we mentioned, that if he's walking on the right side of the road, if Shaitan is walking on the right side, he'll walk on the left side. That is how much of fright the people had, the non-Muslims had, even Shaitan had for Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala. When they looked at him, they saw that Jalal in him. And whenever he stood up for the sake of Allah and His Rasul Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If he loved anyone, he loved for Allah and His Rasul. And if he hated anyone, he hated them for Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was khalis. So he said that Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala, because he was so close to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the first hadith we start with is Kitab al-Iman. They talk about your Iman. Which means that if your Iman is not correct, what you believe in, your Ibadat is not accepted. If your belief is not right, if your Aqidah is not right, there is no use of making Ibadat, because you're making Ibadat for no use. And when you make ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want to see you just making ibadat. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see how well you perfect His beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Allah loves His Habib's action. If Allah's Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put His head down in sajda, Allah loved it. So Allah says, you must do it too. Why did He put His head down for sajda? For what reason? He did it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved it. That is why today even we, when we read namaz, we put our head in sajda. We go in ruku, we stand in qiyam. Why? Because it was taught by our Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is said, Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu was also a sahabi whose life came out in the salah. In a sense that he was performing the namaz of Fajr namaz in between the member of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and a slave came with a knife and poked him in his chest. And Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala made shaheed on the musalla of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And he was buried also by the feet of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. If you go even today, alhamdulillah, you will see As Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala was so close to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, that Allah gave him that opportunity of being buried by the feet of our Nabi Muhammad Mustafa. You know, it was also said that when Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala became a Muslim, as I said before, the angels, they rejoiced. They said, today Islam is going to spread. But the day Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala was made shaheed, that is the day they could hear voices coming out from the walls to say, today Islam has lost a very great person. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this hadith of Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala give him a high rank in Jannah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us also be with him in the day of Qiyamah inshaAllah. So, and Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, qala baynahuma nahnu inda Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala says, qala baynahuma nahnu inda Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That we were sitting one day with our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sahaba ikram were present in the masjid, and they all were sitting and they were talking. And he, Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala himself, was present. Zata yomin, one day, iza tala'a alayna rajul, and then a person showed himself, alayna rajul, a man, shadidul biyazi. He had white clothes on, pitch white. Siyab al-shadid is so hard to shed. He had white clothes and black hair. La yura alayhi safar. La yura alayhi asr safar. Wa la yak rifahu mina ahadun hatta janasa ila Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, this man, he just came into the masjid. He came in front of us with white clothes, pitch white clothes. And his hair was black and long. La yura alayhi asru safar. That we didn't see on him any sign of him being on a journey. Because it is a desert. And in desert, if you travel from one place to the other place, your hair will get messed, your clothes will get messed. But this man, they never see him before. He just came into the masjid like that. First time they're seeing him. His clothes was white. He didn't have any signs of making safar, any journey. La ya'rafahu, and they didn't know who he was. Mina ahad, from all of us that were sitting there, hatta janasa ila Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from all of us that were sitting there in the company of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, nobody knew him. And what did he do? Hatta janasa ila Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, janasa ila Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he sat down in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah, fa asnada rukbatayhi ila rukbatayhi wa wada'a kaffayhi ala fakhzayhi. He said, he sat down in front of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and he put his knees in the same place where Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had his knees, which means he's sitting right in front of him. He's looking at him, and that man is looking at Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Allahu Akbar. Sahaba ikram didn't know who he was. Like, he didn't go on a journey, he didn't come from a journey. What was he doing? Where did he come from? Nobody knew him. And just like that, he comes and he sits with his knees touching the beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were shocked. La yarafu. And they didn't know who he was. He didn't have any sign of any dirt on his body. He sat next to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. Fa asnada rukbatayhi ila rukbatayhi wa wada'a kaffayhi. And then he kept his hand on top of his leg like this. Fakhzayhi. وَقَالَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ. And then he says, يَا مُحَمَّدْ أَخْبِرْنِي عَلِي الْإِسْلَامِ. Oh Muhammad, tell me about Islam. What is Islam? Allahu Akbar. قَالَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ أَخْبِرْنِي عَلِي الْإِسْلَامِ. Give me some news about Islam. What is Islam? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, قَالَ الْإِسْلَامُ أَن تَشْهَدَ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Islam is to give shahadat that there is no God but Allah, and the beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his Rasul and Messenger. Wa tuqimus salah. Subhanallah. Allah's Habib Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam said, Islam is not only to read namaz. Wa tuqimus salah. Provide a place where people can stand and make salah. Like a masjid. Why do you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, anyone that builds the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will build the house for him in Jannah. So Allah's hukum is that, not only read namaz, to keep us salah, build that place of that masjid where people can read namaz. Wa tu'ti zakat, and give your zakat. Wa tasumu ramzan, and to keep fast in the month of Ramadan. Wa tahajjal bayt an istata'a ilayhi sabila. He says that you must go for Hajj at least once in your lifetime. But what he says? In istata'ata ilayhi sabil. Only if he has the means to do so. Now subhanAllah. You see, one of the first in Islam. You have 5 pillars of Islam. From them there is 1 pillar of Islam that is farz, is compulsory. But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you have the means to do so. Some people haven't got no food in the house, but they want to go for Hajj. Got no money to pay the bond off. Got no money to pay those people that they owe money to, but they want to go for Hajj. But it's the Tao, if you have that power, if you have that money or that wealth to go for Hajj, then only it is farz on you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it so easy. Sometimes we leave our wives 40 days in the house, 6 months in the house, 1 year they're gone for Jama'ah. Are they doing justice to Islam, to that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them? They gone for 40 days to chillah, but they got no food in the house, the wife and children are staying alone. Allah says, if you have the istita'at, if you have the power to do it, then go. Then only this far. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us hidayat. That way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even that thing which is farz upon us, if you don't have that wealth or that strength to do it, it's fine, no problem. No. Allah will accept. So he says, to go for Hajj. Hajj of Allah in istata'a ilayhi sabila, if you have the means to do so. Qala sadaqta, fajabna lahu yas'alu, wa yusaddaqu. Allahu. Sahaba Ikram now is sitting there and they're watching and they're hearing. This man is asking the question to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And after the answer of whatever he was asking him, at the end he's saying, yes, you have said the truth. Which means that he also knew the answers. When you say, yes, you are telling the truth, he knew the answers. And he was asking Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given khair kaseer. Allahu Akbar. Allah wants to show you the knowledge of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Qala fa sadaqta. He was saying yes. They were shocked. Yes, alu wa yasaddaqahu. He's asking the question and then he's saying the question is right also. Qala fa akhbirni anil iman. Then this man says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, give me some knowledge about iman. What is iman? Qala an tu'minu billahi. To have iman, to believe in Allah wa malaikatihi, the angels of Allah, wa kutubihi, and those kitabs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down, wa rusulihi, and the rasuls of Allah. They say 124,000 nabis and rasul that came down to the 124,000. We must believe in them all. Wal yawm al akhir, and the day, and the last day. Wa tu'minu bil qadri khayri wa sharrihi. Qala sadaqta. Subhanallah. The second question was, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell us what is iman. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, iman is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his angels, Jibra'il, Mika'il, Israfil, to believe in the kitab, the Zabur, the Injil, those kitabs that came before, those that people changed for themselves, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the last prophet, number one, number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the last Quran. Why? Because they were changing the Quran. So we must believe in them. Wa rusulihi. And all the Nabis and the Rasuls of Allah we must believe in. 124,000 Nabis and Rasul we must believe in. See Adam alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and all the other Nabi, Dawud alayhi salam, Shisa alayhi salam, all we must believe in. Wal yawmil akhir, and the last day. That the day of judgment is going to come. Do not think the day of judgment is not going to come. Day of judgment is coming. We all going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will play like a tape recorder or video. playing record forward and backward. Your whole life will be playing in front of you. Allah will ask you a question, you can't lie. You can't hide. And Allah will give you that punishment according. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have the awliya ikram, the sahaba ikram, and our beloved Habib Muhammad and Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make intercession for us, inshaAllah.
Amen.
Tu'minu bil qadri. Then you must have iman in taqdeer. What is taqdeer? Qadr. Sharri, khairihi wa sharri. Taqdeer that is good and that is bad. Like for example, if you're going somewhere today, like for example today, I'll give you a good example today, once Allah will send this thing, it's not about today. He got robbed. Money was taken, cell phone was taken. But it was written like that. But what happened with that? His money went, the card went, whatever went, but his life didn't. You'll never know his life would have went. But that was taqdeer of Allah. Allah has a different plan for him in the coming in the future. Maybe Allah, if they took 100 grand, they'll give him 1,000 grand. It's Allah's karam. You must have sabr, whatever Allah gives you, whether it's good, whether it's bad. It's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we must believe. And there are certain types of knowledge and certain things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written already that cannot change. And people don't know. Like for example, it is said, you don't know when you're going to die. You don't know which day it is, how you're going to die. You don't know. You don't know whether a lady is pregnant, whether a child, whether a boy or a girl. You don't know. Allah's knowledge this.
Subhanallah.
The day of Qiyamah, you don't know. It's the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't know. Yes, but if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives some people that understanding to understand and give you an answer beforehand, whether it's a boy or a girl, that's Allah's karam. That's Allah's knowledge. If you want to give you, He give you. That's why we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given our Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam khairi kaseer. So much of knowledge. Even knowledge of taqdeer. And there are some taqdeers of Allah which is written already. But can change because of the dua of maybe the awliya. Some taqdeer change because of the dua of a Nabi.
Wow.
Many people say it can't change. How can taqdeer not change? If you say taqdeer can't change, then there's no. What's the use you being in the earth? That means, for example, your birth is written, your death is written. Where are you going to go? You're going to go Jannah, you're going to go Jahannam, it's written already. So what's the use living your life? No. Allah's knowledge is so vast that He knows beforehand. If you put something here, you say this is right and then it's wrong. You say, right, Banda, this is right, this is wrong. Which side are you going to pick? Allah knows beforehand whether you're going to pick the right hand or the left hand.
Subhanallah.
That is the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers in Islam, there's some kind of taqdeer which also changes by the dua of the awliya, by the dua of those people that are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why you find people running to the alim to make dua, Ya Allah. They phone, Ya Allah, I've got a problem. Pick up the phone, make dua. We make dua, Allah changes. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of that. Then he says further, khairihi, sharrihi, qala sadaqta. Then this man that is sitting there, he says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have said the truth. So Allah. He's asking the question and he's still saying yes. Okay, fine. Faqbirni alal ihsan, ikhlas. Ya Allah, what, Ya Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is ikhlas? To be khalis. To be pure inside. What is the meaning of that? And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, قَالَ إِنِّي تَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. Allahu Akbar. Ikhlas, the purity of your heart, is when you're making ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ. You must think that you are looking at Allah. You are looking at Allah when you're reading your salah, when you're making ibadah. And if you can't think that you are looking at Allah, you must always remember Allah is watching you. Then the niyat inside you will be khas, will be pure. No matter what type of ibadah it is. Whether you move something from the road that can hurt someone, that is also ibadah. If your heart is pure, khalis, that you must do something in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing and thinking in your heart that you are watching Allah, Allah is watching you. That is ihsan. فَأَكْبِرْنِي عَنِ السَّعَرُ. Say, Ya Rasulullah says, tell me about the Qiyamah. When will be Qiyamah? قَالَ مَنْ مَسْئُولْ عَنْهَا بِإِعْلَمَ مَنْ سَعَلَ اللَّهُ. Here, you can understand the knowledge of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is so much that he says, this person asked him, Ya Rasulullah, tell me about Qiyamah. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, the one that is asking the question does not have more knowledge than I have. Allah, about the day of Qiyamah. Which means Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had the knowledge of the last day. And Jibreel Amin also had the knowledge. They said, the one that's asking the question knows also the same that I know as well. And he left it like that. قَالَ فَأَكْبِرْنِي أَنْ أَمَارَتَهَا قَالَ أَنْ تَلِدِ الْأَمَانَتَهُ رَبَّتَهَا أَنْ تَرَاهُ غُفَاتُ الْقُرَاتُ عَالِيَةُ رِعَاءَ الشَّارِ يَتَطَاوَلُونَ فِي الْبُنْيَانِ قَالَ سُمَّ إِنْ تَلَكَ لَبِسْتُ مَلِيًا قَالَ سُمَّ لِي يَا عُمَرْ أَتَتْرِي عَلِي السَّارِ. He says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi, give me some signs of Qiyamah. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, a slave will give birth to a king. One of the signs of Qiyamah. Antarat, hafatul urat al-aliyat. And you will find that people that didn't have clothes, people that used to round up the sheep, they will be people that will be staying in big, big amarats, big, big houses. And then he says, summa antalaka. Then this man, he left Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. He turned and he went away. قَالَ لِي يَا عُمَرْ أَتَدْرِي مَنِ السَّعَرِ. He says, Ya Umar, do you know who that person was that was asking those questions? قُلْتُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ وَعَلَى. He says, Allah and Rasul knows best. Some people say, Ya Allah, why are you saying Allah and Rasul together? What is the problem? What is the problem? Why are you using Rasul? Why don't say Allah? Allah and Allah knows best. Why are you saying Allah and His Rasul knows best? Because Allah gave His Nabi that knowledge of everything that you have today. Summa inna atainaka al-kawthar. Ya Rasulullah, give me so much. The size of your world. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew, and then this man turned and he went in. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam asked, Ya Rasul, Ya Umar, do you know who this man is? And قُلْ تُوَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ عَلَمُ. He said, Allah and His Rasul knows best. قَالَ فَإِنَّهُ جِبْرَائِيلُ. He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam said, فَإِنَّهُ جِبْرَائِيلُ أَتَاكُمْ يُعَلِّمُكُمْ دِينُكُمْ. He said, that was Jibreel alayhi salam that came to teach you your deen. Allah. Look at those sahaba ikram. How great they were. That Jibreel Yameen came, he sat next to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam and he was explaining to Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam and asking him questions about Islam, about Iman. Why? Because there is nobody in this earth that was given more knowledge that was given to Nabi alayhi salam. Some people, ma'azallah, they believe that Malak al-Maut got more knowledge than Nabi alayhi salam. Jibreel got more knowledge than Nabi alayhi salam. No. Allah gave our beloved Habib, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, so much of knowledge of Allah, that Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, he says, by looking at my palm, I can see exactly what's happening in the dunya. That is how much of knowledge the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had inside him. Rawah Muslim, and this hadith was recorded in Muslim Sharif, which is also another kitab of hadith, which is authentic. There's absolutely no doubt in the hadith. Every word in this hadith is according to those words that came out from our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We learned many things here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of Quran, understanding of hadith and the way of our beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To remember always that Islam is to give witness that Allah is one and His beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Rasul. To be musallah and to make a place or to make that kind of jamaat where a person can read salah. Wa tu'tu zakat, to give zakat, to keep fast in the month of Ramadan. To go for Hajj. In istata'a sabila, only if you have the power to do so. Then he said, the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was asked about Iman, about Islam. Those were the words that was given. When he says about Iman, he says you must have Iman in Allah, in Malaika, in the Kitabs of Allah, in the Rasuls of Allah, in the last day. Have Iman in Qadr. Whether it's bad, it's good. You must have knowledge of it. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam knew, and the person that was asking Jibreel, I mean, knew the answer to it, but they were there to explain and to teach to the Sahaba ikram. Then Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says about ikhlas, how we must make ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you remember one thing, that if Allah is watching you 24/7, wallahi, you won't make any guna. And if you think that Allah is watching you, or you are watching Allah, that ibadah that you do, whatever you do in your life, you'll be doing it for Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise you won't do it. So please remember that when you make ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember that Allah is watching you. Or if Allah is not watching you, you are watching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then about the last day, which is the day of Qiyamah, the signs of Qiyamah, where it won't be a slave, will give birth to a king. You'll never see that in your life. But if that day happens, that day comes, you must know that day is Qiyamah. And when you find those people that used to walk with no clothes, people that got in Jahiliyyah, they got no knowledge of Quran, knowledge of Hadith, no knowledge, stupid people. Now we say stupid people. You tell somebody something, you say, yeah, he's stupid, he's pagal, he's stupid. Eh? Then you find people like that who will be living in big, big houses, skyscrapers. That also a sign of Qiyamah itself. And then he says that those people also that used to bring the sheep together, the herdsmen, they will also be living in big skyscrapers. That is also a sign of Qiyamah. And then he said that this man left the bargah of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, Ya Umar, that was Hazrat Jibreel Amin, sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach you about Islam, about Iman, about Ikhlas, and to teach you about the last day, which is the day of Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of Hadith, which is about Iman, and make us better Muslims for the future. Wa ma alina illa al-balagh al-mubin. Jazakumullahu khair. Amin. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa laqibatul muttaqeen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulihi Muhammadin. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Ya Rasulullah, unzur halana. Ya Habibullah, isma qalana. Innana fi bahriha min mudrakun. Khuzyati sahillana ashqalana. Allahumma taqabbal hazihi darsi hadith ma'a jamaatil muslimin. إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا مولانا وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه بفضل سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين بحق لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وصحبه وبارك وسلم